On the line now, I have a young man who's all the way from Restrever. And a silly idea, simple little idea he had actually to entertain his friends has just exploded. Mark Hughes, are you there?
I am indeed. How are you doing?
I'm very well. I'm very intrigued, Mark, by this big nerdy quiz that has just taken off, like flying off the shelves faster than the wine in the supermarkets. Tell us all about it. What is the big nerdy quiz?
So the big nerd pub quiz was a wee idea I came up with last week, actually. It was around about Wednesday afternoon. I was out with my dad doing a few messages, and I just thought, you know, I love quizzes. I've been doing them since I was a kid, like doing the old credit union primary school quizzes, and I came home. I know, yeah, we won it one year, like, yeah, actually. I came home from London there a couple of weeks ago, and I came home from London last week because all the work dried up. Because, you know, there's no more, yeah. I work in live music, and all the gigs just dried up. So I decided to come home to be with my family, and I've got a little bit bored, and I thought, you know what would be a really good idea? If we did a pub quiz, but we did it over Skype or YouTube or something like that.
Yeah.
And I thought I'd come up with the idea, like, because I'm a massive Trekkie nerd, like, you know, and I thought I want to do it about stuff that my mates will like. So I came up with the idea, but after a wee while, like, the word kind of got around, like, you know, and more people said, oh my God, that's a fantastic idea. Let's do it. And by the time we actually did it on Saturday night, about 800 people were taking part in it.
Wow.
And about 5,000 people were watching it on YouTube. So I was like, oh my God.
You must be like a boy band. You've suddenly become huge.
Oh God, yeah. I don't know which boy band they were, like, you know, but I'd tell you one thing. It's just been mad seeing it, and all the people watching it all around the place. It's magic. Like,
tell us a wee bit how it works, Mark. I can't quite picture it. Is it you on a screen? We tune in and we see you giving out questions, or what?
Basically, it's a YouTube live stream. I kind of had to learn all how to do this on the hop. I rang a buddy of mine down in Dublin to tell me how to do the graphics, and another friend of mine to teach me how to, you know, figure out how to manage the channel and get subscribers and everything like that. So I'm basically doing everything about it, you know, the research in it, the graphics, the producing and the driving of it and the presenting of it. And basically it's me on YouTube on a live stream. And basically, the questions come up below me. I read them out and the questions come up. And everyone takes part by logging on to this Google form. And there's multiple choice questions. So even if you don't know the answer, have a go. You might get it anyway.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah, you can always give a question or an answer. Yeah,
that's pretty much it. And people, you know, there was a couple of hiccups with the first one, the first quiz that we did, in that I had a movie round. And I was playing clips from movies, and you had to guess the next line. And because YouTube don't like you using copyrighted materials, like, they cut the sound out of it. I was like, oh my God, what the hell? So it was kind of like trying to do this on the hop. And at one point, I was like writing on a piece of paper and holding it up to the camera going, we're still doing this. Keep going. And but then it's been mad crack, like, you know, and
it sounds fantastic.
Actually kind of exhausting as well.
Yes, well, I mean, you were saying to me when I had a quick chat with you earlier on that it's basically taken over your life. But what a great thing to have. It's lovely to be doing, to be busy. I feel that about coming in here to do the show. Isn't it wonderful to have something to do and to feel like you're reaching out to people and you're doing something that you enjoy, even if you're not at the moment anyway making any money from it?
Well, that's the thing. Like, I came in, I've actually been more busier doing this, you know, in the last week than I have been in the last couple of, you know, in the last month. And it's really, it takes about 3 days to prep. Like, I have to research the questions from scratch. And because the last quiz was quite niche, you know, if you had to be into your science fiction and your films and your comic books and your games, and so many people got involved with it and they really enjoyed it. But the feedback I got was like, let's make it more general knowledge. So this time around, I've decided to add a sports round, a literature round, a geography round and a politics round.
And where are you getting your questions from?
I just make them up.
Right.
Because I kind of figure, like, I've done a couple of quiz shows on TV as well. Like, you know, so I kind of figure, like, I know the kind of thing that's asked and the kind of style in which it's asked.
Yeah.
So we've kind of figured.
We're going to be looking at you on a screen, putting out the questions. And then what do we need to do? Where do we go to join in, let's say?
So if you just Google Big Nerd Pub Quiz. And it's we're on. If you go onto YouTube, it's Big Nerd Pub Quiz there. Also on Facebook, I'm on all the social media channels as well. I think that's the best way to kind of get in touch with people and make them aware of it. So I'm on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Like, and it's just a setup. So I do all the social media management for that as well. Which again,
so you know, if I go on, I'm speaking like a bit of a technophobe.
Aye.
I go on, Josephine Punter, and there's simple instructions there. And when I put my answers in, then where do they go? Do you see the answers, or how does the... Because you gave a prize last weekend. I think you're going to have to stop giving like 50 quid of your own money each time.
Yeah.
How do you get the answers, and how do you decide who's won?
So like I said, it comes on like basically it's a Google form, and each round there's going to be 8 rounds of 6 questions, and you pick the answer from multiple choice. And once I've done the quiz live, and the beauty about it is once you log on, you can't see the questions, but you can see the answers. You need to listen to me giving you the questions so you can know which one to answer. And then as the quiz ends, you press submit and it automatically comes to me, and I can see exactly who's answered what. And it even gives me like a breakdown of which questions worked, as in, you know, which ones were really, really hard, which ones stumped people, and which ones actually everybody got. So it's quite intuitive. It's actually really, really user-friendly. Like, so you go on the YouTube, the link will be in the description below, and you just click that and away it goes.
And then you're not sitting totting up all the answers and deciding it all. That's fantastic, because I've done pub quizzes or, you know, charity quizzes in my time, and there's people sitting there reading all the answers. So you're not doing all of that. That's how it's possible to do it with so many people. So even if there's thousands of people taking part, it's on tonight at what time?
It's on tonight at 8 o'clock. The broadcast will start at about 7:30 to give a chance everyone to get logged in and get settled down. And, you know, if you want to kind of just add to the pub atmosphere, you know, just get a couple of drinks on the go, you know.
Responsibly.
Of course. And you know what? With all pub quizzes, you know, there's just that kind of idea of like, you know, everyone get their phone out and Google it. And okay,
you
that,
could.
There's a trust.
There's no point.
Could do that, but you're only cheating yourself.
Exactly. Like, exactly. And that's what I always think. What's the point in winning if you know that you cheated? So how are you going to know? When will you give out the winner for tonight? Is that another time? Will that be at the next one?
But generally, what I'll do is I'm going to see if I can try to get a leaderboard and try to put that up. And you know, the prize will be the glory of knowing that you've beaten,
exactly,
you know, 800, 900 people. Like, you know, that's the thing. And on the whole, I have looking at the last quiz, most of the people were honest. Like, well, in fairness, like I got one of the questions wrong. Oh God, because I'm doing all the research myself, and God, I got one of the I said it was one thing, and it really was another. And
they hate that. They'll jump all over you.
Yeah. Oh, everybody knew about that.
Well, listen, can I say thank you so much? I know you're going to have a button on there tonight that if people want to express their appreciation for all the work you're doing, they can throw in a pound or 50p or whatever. If you've all those people doing it, maybe it'll make it actually worth your while monetarily, because I'm sure it's very hard when there's no money coming in. But you're doing it for the fun at this point. So listen, thank you, Mark. I hope
that's
people
my Patreon.
Will enjoy it. Okay. People just go to Big Nerd Pub Quiz on YouTube.
It's my Patreon page as well.
I've got a Patreon page.
If you want to give me a price of a pint or a cup of coffee, by all means.
All right. Listen, Mark, thanks a million. You've got the questions. We'll see you there later on this evening. Thanks very much for that. Ah, what a great thing. And our next song now. Yes, this is Maria McKee. This is Show Me Heaven. And this was requested yesterday. Liam Cunningham. I know I have it here. Give a shout out to Liam Cunningham in Warren Point for going out over and beyond to help me last night in this worrying time. That's from Maria. Well, that would have been a couple of nights ago. Delighted to be able to do that for Liam. Thanks for all your help.